There are radiations of various spheres through communication signals. They even affect the body. That is radiation. The third thing is infection, I have already told. Apart from these radiation things, I have already told about inheritance. By heredity, you can get a lot of such problems. So this type of various things that will result in the emergence of cancer. Now the World Cancer Society, they have given 8 major reasons for cancer. Number one is tobacco. Number one they have rated as tobacco. Second is alcoholism. That is very essential. Third thing is very beautiful. More vegetables and fruits you consume, lesser the risk of cancer is there. People, they have started taking lot of other things, cereals, pulses and various other things. Even now they are not taking that. They are just drinking oil and spices in the pretext of a few morsels of rice inside it. So now they are consuming only spices and oils, and more than that they are consuming only urea, potassium and other fertilizers which are just mixed with food. What we are taking is just the urea, potassium and other fertilizers decorated with grains, cereals and pulses. That's what we are taking. So this type of unhealthy food habits, in which foods, mainly it must possess fruits and vegetables, because fruits and vegetables are born out of the same earth in which we are dwelling. We are having institutional as well as configurative fraternity. That is Stavara and Jangama, they have constitutional fraternity. Even the so-called carnivorous animals, they don't consume carnivorous animals, only herbivorous. So there is a process of mutual understanding between these two kingdoms, plant and animal kingdom. So consuming these things, that will create more immunity, because they are exposed to two things. One is Dhyava and Prithivi. We are having floors and we are seated inside, we are having huts with roofs. So our exposure to the real Prithivi and Dhyava is being concealed. So reduced our immunity and response to the drugs and any other medical supports. So the only thing that is deeply fixed within the earth, as well as totally exposed to the sky, Dhyava Prithivi, Shivate Ubhestam. This is absolutely followed only by plants. So vegetables and fruits, they must be 2/3 of our meals. And 1/3 it must be anything. It is advocated by the World Cancer Research Council. Fruits and things. Fourth thing is physical exercise. Movement of your physical body that will prevent as unwanted material to be stagnated in some areas which may result in malignant tumor. The fourth thing. The fifth thing is unsafe sex. And the sixth thing is lot of other consumed things are connected with lot of pollutions. Full pollution in food, pollution in water and pollution in air. That's why we used to say the man has beautified earth but spoiled water, food and air. We told in one environmental congress. So he has made everything beautiful at the cost of making these three basic ingredients ugly. That is very worst. So this is very much essential to know that the pollution is also having the same effect. So all of these various factors have been given by the Cancer Research Council. Some other factors are so that we cannot discuss all things today. Let me come to the conclusion. Number one, there are three things I have already told. One is inherited. Just to putting everything in a precise package, there are reasons from the atmosphere, surroundings. There are reasons from your inner body, in your inner spirit. There are reasons which are out of inheritance. For removing these things only, our ancestors needed the support of three mega forces. For getting benefits which are their inner built and which are innate, they worshipped the Pitrus, the ancestors. For removing the maladies which are come out of the inheritance, they worship the rishis, the Gotra Mulapurushas. And for control over the surrounding forces and the domination and pollution, they worship the Devatas. So whatever the inner reasons, contribution of the degradation, whatever the surroundings, whatever the inherited reasons, by sincere, loyal worship and divine approach towards the ancestors, the primogenitors as well as the celestial authorities, Rishi, Pitru, Devata. They have been worshipped by our traditions for giving inner sources, inherited sources and circumstantial sources of favor. We have forgotten those things. We have forgotten not only to do those things, but also to patronize those people who are doing these things incessantly. Due to lack of patronage, you have left already due to insincerity and your misfortune. You also made these people to lose their practices, leave their practices. It is our duty to start it today and also to encourage and empower such embodiments of knowledge and practice to continue this three process of worship, which is going to contribute at least 65% or 70%, let 30% your research, your scrutiny, lab experiments, let them come for rescue. More than what you do now, I don't want you to stop any of the experiment, medication or research. You do that thing, but do the thing with real spirit, real value. Let it be vivified, your spirit, let it be vivified by your spiritual understanding and practice. Let us couple together the modern research, which is like an orphaned child in a festival. The science is like an orphaned child in a festival. It is just blinking here and there what to do and when to do and what will be the result. Let the orphaned child be embraced by the mother of our traditional knowledge. Let both of them dwell in mutual understanding, which will result in the prosperity, salubrity and spiritual tranquility, overall happiness to all members of this global society. Narayan, Narayan, Narayan. Epigenetics, it deals with the response of your inner genes. Response of your inner genes inside a genome or inside a DNA. So these things cannot be activated in modern science except in genomics and pharmacogenomics. So to take a genomic exercise and to send a message to your inner cell, it will take at least $10 million for you to research and do the same thing. But with our sincerity, love and affection towards God, we can do it without even a penny price of expense. We can do that. That is there. So epigenetics is the study of inner response. So the response or the message apprehension of your own inbuilt genes inside your genome as well as inside a DNA can be activated only by a spiritual process. So what we have to do is by proper medication and evaluation by a group of people in various communities. For example, there is also a process of screening and genetic testing. Genetic testing is there. Screening is there. Now we are in chemo prevention. Each and everybody, before getting into cancer, there are some drugs which are infused inside, which will totally prevent the possibility of cancer. That is not as chemotherapy, but chemo prevention. That is modern science is there. You take some of these chemotherapies and preventive oncologists, put them in a lobby, whereby you just test a patient and produce his report, and also the report before the treatment and after the treatment, it can be very easily done. Epidemiology is very important. Epidemiology is a very important science. Certain people working in certain atmospheres, unavoidably they will get certain cancers. For example, persons who are with the chimney sweep, they are affected by the scrotum cancer. Recently they have discovered. So if you are having that much of mentality, for example, drug addiction is there. For example, alcoholism is more. For example, the working atmosphere is radioactive. It is very hyper polluted. If persons working in an area are living even in an area where there is pollution rate more, they will get some diseases, epidemiology. So epigenetics, that is known as inner response of your body, and epidemiology is the outer response to your body. This must be, that is what I call holistic. You are having yoga, and yoga is a mind sense. You are transmitting your higher level of mind and consciousness with utmost divinity, purity, serenity towards some other person. If you are not a good producer, if he is not a good receptacle, if the medium is not good, even though we are deserving and desiring, then we may not get the result. So for any support as supplementary issues, we must treat some portions of sciences like basic pathology, pathobiology, pathophysiology, this epidemiology and epigenetics. We can keep, no doubt, we must keep some areas for detection, for proper diagnosis, assurance and evaluation of our body growth and progress. Certainly we must have a holistic system. Whenever we join together with modern technology as well as our traditional technology, that area will going to be a successful area where everybody is going to accept the greatness of our art.
We always discuss this Ayurveda in Charaka Samhita, the first chapter, in the 17th shloka. It is clearly stated that when Bharadwaja went to Brahmadeva to get the knowledge of Ayurveda, he was in Dhyanavastha. Now that is a crucial thing. If you are going to do any research, according to me, on Ayurveda, you have to do, you mentioned that Dhyana and Dharana, that has got some different objective, but Samadhi is one way of getting into that, what Bharadwaja did to get this knowledge of Ayurveda. Patanjali has clearly stated, Nabhi Chakra Sharira Vyodhyana. Now, today I find that this aspect of Ayurvedic knowledge which is really obtained by Bharadwaja is totally ignored. I asked one of the students of Ayurveda, he knew this, worse he knew, he suggests chapter 1, verse 17 contains all these particular things. I say, what do you do with that? He say, we ignore it totally and completely.
Yes.
Sir, is there a way to get into this mode of obtaining medicines for cancer as well as